What is the meaning of function? What is the meaning of function? Why we will write the function?
In order to execute a specific task.
Okay. What are the advantages of using function?
Can be stored, easy to write, and
can be reusable, can be used again.
Can be stored and used again.
Okay, code reuse, right?
Yeah.
Okay, any other uses? Yeah, carry on. Debugging will be easy, right?
Yes.
Because if you write the same code multiple times, okay, if you want to change in one place, you have to change in so many places. There will be a chance of missing. And if you keep in one place and if you are calling the same piece of code multiple times, if there is any issue or any code, any problem with the code, we can update the changes in one place. Agree? Why we have to read the code? For avoiding the duplication of the code and for maintaining the code cleanliness, for making debug easy, right? There is no use of writing the same piece of code multiple times. Whenever you are doing something, okay, try follow the same thing. Okay, Python principle is there, okay, on Django principle. Try, do not repeat yourself. Once you did, try to reuse it.
So is it like a package in Java?
It is a different concept. Package, it will come like multiple between multiple files. Okay, now we are thinking about only one file.
Oh, okay, okay.
Function. Function means we are doing a small task with that function. Okay, now assume you are writing addition function. Simple example I am taking. Or getting the age. If I give the data of birth, okay, if I am providing your data of birth, I have to get the age of yours. Means, okay, if he is 90, okay, I have to give age 26. If it is 85, I have to give age 25, like that, 30, like that, right?
Yeah.
If I am calculating an event's date of birth, okay, I will mention the date, okay, is equal to 90, okay, August 19th, 1990, then get the age. Then again I am calculating for Chris. Chris date of birth is this and do it. Instead of doing this one, I will calculate if I will write a function, one function, take date of birth as input parameter and return the age as a output value. Right? Okay. Instead of writing the same piece of code multiple times, I can do like this.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Then what is the thing? The same logic will apply. Okay, get the current timestamp and get the difference of between the years and months. Based on that, you can plus or minus 1 year, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, this is how the function means, like instead of writing for so many places, I can write in one place. Whenever I need, I can invoke it.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Got it.
Okay. That is a simple function thing. Okay. Now, okay, you are doing subjects again. Okay. You are getting the grade for the Naveen, okay, he for his MS, okay, we are passing subject names or subject marks as a input values and getting the grade, right? The same thing we can do for all the people, right? Remaining people also we can use the same thing. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay, if you are functions, okay, whenever you are writing the code, make it as a small tasks, okay? Getting the average is a one task. And small small task, like okay, only one unit of functionality, one related functionality needs to be there. Okay.
Okay, each must be written separately with different function names, or in the same function?
Yeah, in different functions, as we can do it.
Function.
Yeah.
Okay.
So getting the age by taking the input. Okay, that is one function.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Now your simple example. We have a conversion between the temperature, right? Fahrenheit to Celsius. Okay, that is simple
yeah.
thing. Okay, that function has to do only one thing. What it has to do? Either it has to take input as a parameter as a Fahrenheit and then convert into Celsius. That is one function. And Celsius to Fahrenheit is another function.
Okay.
One small task, okay, can be performed making that one as a function. Small, small task, building blocks, like don't write a big functions because all the logic involved in one function, that is not a good thing. Make it as a small, small tasks, okay?
Debugging will be easy.
Yeah, correct. Okay.
And one more thing, if we write a function right now, can we use that function in every other program, or is it going to stay for that particular program? That's
yeah, wait, wait. Okay, I will come there, okay?
Yeah.
Now, we will deal related to one file right now, okay? Now I will discuss about the syntax.
Yeah.
Okay. Now see how you write the functions in other programming function. Okay, return value, okay?
Yeah.
The general, I'm taking this one, Java syntax.
Okay, function is nothing but a method in Java, right?
Yeah.
The kind of method.
Yeah, correct. Public void, func name. Okay, you will mention the arguments.
Yeah.
You will mention the arguments here. In case of some integer, okay, value, return value, in the end, you will be rendered, right? You will write piece of code like this. Agree?
Yeah.
This is about in other programming language.
Yeah.
This is the syntax in other programming language. How the same thing will be in Python? We will see. Def function name. Function name. Arguments. Whatever the arguments you will call, double quote means, once I kept the double quote means I am starting of a block, function starting tab, okay, till how much I follow till that point of time, this three lines is related to this function. Got it?
Okay.
Okay.
Based on the indentation, it will identify what are the lines of code related to that function.
Okay.
Any queries you have? This is the signature of a function. Function signature. How you will define a function in a Python. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we will take simple thing. Now what I will do was, I am taking just some welcome message, okay, print message I am giving, okay. Now what I am doing, I declared a function, agree?
Yeah.
I defined a, declared and defined a function. Now how to invoke the function? Call simply print message off. Now see, if you see, it is printing, right? Welcome to Python programming. If I won't call the function, if you declare the function, define the function also, this won't be executed unless until you call.
So it will, it will only compile and keep.
Yeah, correct. No, functions.
Okay, so here we can call the function directly rather than writing any main method or like execution logic class. Rather than writing any execution logic class, you can directly call a function.
Yeah, correct. We can do it.
Python.
Yeah.
Okay.
There is no need of main method. Okay. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, if I want to call, how many times I can call? Now I am doing again. Before definition, I am checking. Okay, at line number 4, the definition is not available because whenever I am interpreting, it is interpreter, right? Okay,
yeah.
Whenever I am doing, I invoked the function call, but till now I didn't found. Once I made that one, define the definition, then only I can invoke it. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, if I want to call multiple times, print multiple times, I can print. Now we give 5 times, right? I am giving 5 times. We written a function, okay, we written a simple function just using simple print statement, agree?
Yeah.
Okay, now I will written a function without taking any arguments. Did you observe that one? Doesn't take any arguments. Now what I will do was, I will pass some argument, okay, how to pass the argument, how to use that argument in a function, we will check. Okay. Okay. Now I will do one thing. Details. Printing details. Name comma age. I am taking. Taking the details of print. Is dot format of name comma age. Now I can invoke the function, right? Print details function.
Yeah.
How to pass the parameter? Name one equal to Naveen. Age is equal to 23, age 1. Now can I pass print details, right? Details of name 1 comma age 1.
Yeah.
I can call, right? Naveen age is 23. Okay, I can pass some other arguments. Location. Location staying in I can print the details, right? This function is name, details are this one, name, age, okay, he's staying in interested. Here we give the simple thing, okay, the similar way we can take the marks and get the average, okay, time being I am doing like this, okay.
Okay.
We can do like this, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now I can print Krishna details also.
Yeah.
I can write like this also, the values here.
Directly taking the arguments.
Yeah.
Rather than defining, yeah.
Yeah, correct. 23. Okay. Okay, I will give. Okay, I can give Krishna details also, right?
Yeah, but we have to, okay, oh yeah, got it.
No, I can give another details, name, another variables I will take and I can pass, right? Okay. Now you are passing some arguments. Okay. What will happen? If I miss the location. If I miss the location. Missing one required positional arguments, right?
Yeah.
If we define a function with the arguments, it is expecting some arguments, you are missing some arguments. It is that one we are calling as a required arguments or mandatory arguments. You declared means you have to pass it, that's it.
Okay.
We are calling this one as a mandatory arguments or required arguments. If you pass that one, function signature won't match and it will throw the error. Clear?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what we will do is we will take one simple function. One more exercise we will do with the simple thing. Now we will take that one, right? That okay, we will take a temperature value in a Celsius and convert into Fahrenheit. We will apply the same logic. So many times we will call the same piece of code, it will be executed. One example we will try.
Okay.
Definition convert C to F. Okay.
Yeah.
Here I am passing the Celsius, right? Okay.
Celsius. Yeah.
Temp I am taking. Here what I am doing, okay, what we have to do is first we will print what are the value we received. Okay, temp value in Celsius. Temp. Result equal to temp star. Number 5 plus 32. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. Result. Now what I am doing, I am taking, first I am checking with 37 degrees. Okay, legitimate ones. Okay, if once you've taken 37, what is the value you are getting? 98.6. Okay, now if I give 45, you are able to pass the values, agree?
Yeah.
And making some computation and taking the result. Okay. Now instead of
If
returning here, okay, printing here, I will return the result. I will return the result.
okay.
I will return the result, and I can use like this. Okay, temp one equal to. I am printing. I am take. I return some value. I capture the return value into some variable, and I am printing. Okay. Temp value after conversion. Temp one.
Okay.
Instead of doing there, okay, I am converted value. I am taking. Agree? You are able to pass a argument, and you are able to capture the return value also, right? Passing the argument you know now, and getting the return value from the function also you know.
Yeah.
Next one was simple thing, you understand, right?
Yeah. If what if we pass a string, it will give out an error, right?
We will try. What is wrong? It is unable to make this performance calculation, and it will throw the error. Got it?
Okay. Okay, yeah.
Before doing, okay, you have to mention, okay, invalid value means if you want to do the error handling, you can do like passed value is int data type or float data type, then only accept, otherwise throw error.
Yeah.
Like that you can do. If
yeah.
you keep and try accept back, it will, you can do it under the exception thing, type error we will get.
Okay.
Okay, we will catch up. I will explain that.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, any queries until now? Any queries? Yeah.
So can you explain the program from third line actually?
Okay.
And even like DEF is mandatory, sir, for
yeah,
defining?
This is syntax. DEF. Syntax, this is syntax, you have to declare the function like this only. DEF function name, parenthesis open, if you are passing any parameter you have to mention, otherwise no parameters means close bracket, colon. This is the syntax, you have to declare the function signature like this only, you have to follow. This is a mandatory syntax.
Okay.
It is
and
a
even the program.
Sorry?
Even can you explain the program once again?
Yeah. Okay, here what we are doing, first you are passing some value, right? Okay, in the function whatever the value you passed, you taken that value and you are applying some calculations to get the result. Okay, here in our case what we are doing was, we are taking a simple example of converting a temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Okay, I passed the value as a temperature value as a Celsius, and if you want to convert to Fahrenheit, we have a function called some calculation like whatever the Celsius in degrees, okay, temperature in degrees star 9/5 and plus 32, that is the function. The same function logic we applied here, temperature in Celsius degrees star 9/5. The first star will be executed as a preference thing, because this computation will be done, star will be done, because star is having higher precedence than plus. This is done. Then we are adding plus 32. Okay. Now we will try one more example. It is like, I will take your subject marks. And get the average. Earlier you written in a plain way, okay, now Earlier you are able to do only for one person. Now I can do for multiple persons by invoking the same code. We tried this example, right? I'm mentioning marks. I'm taking three things now. Okay, whenever you are practicing, make like this, like means like for a better understanding purpose, what are the arguments you are passing, print it for a few days, initial few days. Later, once you are comfortable, you can avoid it. Now what are the subject marks I am printing? I got it. Now result is equal to, instead of this one, what you have to do? Subject 1 plus subject 2 plus subject 3. Average. I am printing this one, right? Now I will do average 1. Okay.
Average is equal to divided by 3, fifth line.
Get grade of M possible
and return yeah
that's right
45 50 I'm doing and I can print the average one. What is the return value I'm capturing here in the print statement? The same way I can do for average two. Okay, you can do get the grade for Naveen, you can do get the grade for Krish, okay, by declaring the function and invoke that function, right? You can apply the same logic for so many things. Okay? Okay, once you get the grade, here you can mention, right, based on this grade, you can mention whether it is passed in first class, second class, right? The same logic you can apply here, get grade. Okay, instead of returning average, return A, B, C, like that you can return. Okay, now there is a chance of sometimes here, this is all we discussed about the required arguments, okay, mandatory arguments. Now here what you are doing, here you want to pass a name, age, location. Okay, now what will happen if I pass something like this? If I pass something like this, it is showing Krish age is UK, staying in 23. It is showing little wrong, right?
Yeah.
Because by mistake, user did mistake by arguments swapping, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, it has to show error here because I use it in different format. Print format, I can do like this also, right? Print, I can do like this also.
Yeah.
We have, right, this one percentage S thing we'll keep.
Mm. Okay.
We are not specifying the integer.
Yeah, correct. It will give data type mismatch error. Okay, if you do like this, it will throw error, right? Because I am expecting
integer value.
Numeric value, yeah, numeric value, but you pass a string, it throws the error. Percentage D format a member is required. Okay, it is wrong thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I can make like this also. by using the argument, keyword argument. I can do like this, name equal to location equal to, yes, I can pass the parameters like this also. This one we are calling as a keyword arguments. You are passing the values with the keyword name, parameter name, keyword parameter name. Now execute the same thing.
The parameter, the name for that, those variables should be same, right?
Yeah, correct.
Okay.
Okay. Now it's coming properly. Krish, age 23, staying in UK, right?
Yeah.
If you by mistake, if you thought of interchanging, okay, if you think it can happen, use the keyword arguments.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What the meaning of default arguments? Any idea? Did you heard anything?
What is that?
Default arguments. Default arguments. Okay, we are all studying in one college, assume.
Yeah.
Okay, the software is dedicated for your college.
Yeah.
Do we need to, whenever we are mentioning the student details, what are the student details we'll have? Student
name, age, sex.
Sex, college name, right?
Yeah.
This is the template for each student under the university. Okay, university name, assume. Yeah. University name also there. Okay. Each student will have all these details. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I am preparing the records for okay, Andhra University or Hyderabad Usmania University. No need, do we need to provide the university name each time?
No. We can reuse the university name.
Okay, we can reuse, right? Means, okay, I will show the details later. Print student details I'm taking. The thing, name, time being I will keep 1-3.
Yeah.
University name. University name. I'm printing the details, right?
Yeah.
Now, if I want to get the things, what I have to do? Now I am doing this one. I am printing person name. Okay. Agree? Now I am printing the details. Okay, I am studying in CR Reddy. CR Reddy College belongs to Andhra University. Agree? Now, okay, here we are all are belongs to one university record only. We are passing the parameter, right? Every time. Okay, instead of doing this, I can mention this one. We are calling as a default value.
Okay,
default value. Now see, for the last student Naveen, I didn't pass a Gautam. Sorry, I didn't pass the university name.
Andhra.
But still, it will take as a Andhra University.
Okay.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. If you pass, it will take. If you won't pass, it will take as a default value. Now I will mention Krishri is not belongs to Andhra University, he belongs to Osmania. See what will print for Krish? Will print Osmania University. If you
how did university came? I am not getting it. Like how did university came? We are not printing university.
The print yes. Statement has university in that.
Okay. Sorry.
Okay.
Got it.
See, Krish belongs to Usmania University, right? His college belongs to Usmania. If we pass the value, whatever the value you mentioned, it will take. If you want to pass the value, it will take a default value. Clear? Did you got the concept of default arguments?
Yes.
Okay. Here, there are some rules are there.
Okay.
If you mention it is taking, if you not mention it taking default value. The rule is the default arguments needs to be followed by non-default arguments. Means default arguments followed by non-default means default. I cannot keep non-default arguments after default arguments. If I did like this, what will happen? Tell me. Here, I cannot capture, I am unable to found this value related to the college name or university name. Right? Here, one argument was missing. I am expecting third one. Right? I cannot correlate related to university name or college name.
Okay.
So while passing the details, can we do it college name equal to Gita? While passing the argument in the get student detail,
For all you have to mention, not only for the.
Oh, okay.
For all you have to mention. Got it?
Yeah.
Syntax is, it won't allow first of all, okay, because it will be a confusion. Syntax is non-default or default arguments needs to be followed by a non-default arguments. Means we have to keep always in the end. We have to keep always in the end. Now I can give one more default argument also, country. India. Got it?
Yeah.
Now I can print in Country I can give. India it's showing, right? Now
Yeah.
if I want to, okay, you people are in US. Okay. It is in USA, it is not in India. I am mentioning the
Yeah.
values. This belongs to Harvard University in USA. Got it? Okay. I need one real time example. I am expecting one real time example from you. Where will be the default values? Okay. We all seen whenever we go for the voting elections. If you don't know, they keep by default for younger generation 18, right? Because that is the minimum age. Right?
So, also during courses, if students are attending Java class, so that should be default, right?
Yeah, that should be default. Institute name could be default. Agree? Institute name.
Yeah.
Institute name, because we all are going and enrolling. Enrolling. Okay, institute name will be default,
yeah.
And location is default, means some of the things only available in the Hyderabad only. Okay, that will be thing. Our state name, our country name also default. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. All default arguments needs to be in the end.
Okay.
So clear?
Okay.